Back to sort of focusing that assessment around the highest goal of individual growth. A big part of it is removing that grades and that the grades and that sense of judgment, right? The teacher as the giver of the grade and the person who's going to tell you where you're not measuring up. So in this way, when there's not that pressure of sort of this lasting grade, students are really free to identify those areas where they do still need to grow. And they're much more comfortable, I think, finding those places both where they are really doing well and where and how they need to continue to improve. Additionally, we really focus on putting students in the driver's seat. So as I hope that rubric illustrated, the students are the ones really leading this evaluation. So they fill out that rubric and they lead the conversation in the one-on-ones that we have with them. Focused around that preparation that they did. And we as teachers are then chiming in with, you know, additional questions to sort of push them a little bit further, maybe in their thinking, or offering suggestions to help them as they focus on setting goals for how to improve. And finally, focusing really on their strengths and goals, as opposed to that sort of like deficit-based thinking of here are the places that you aren't quite measuring up. Really, we want to focus on celebrating, like, here's what you've learned, here's what you've did, here's what you've done, and how do you want to continue to improve, and keeping sort of positive motivational focus. And then one of the questions we get a lot, obviously, is how will they learn a broad range of skills if we only focus on their strengths and interests? But what we've found is that we've been really successful in leveraging student interests to improve those areas that we think are important, but may not be quite as interesting to them. So I've taught engineering for a while now, and one of the big areas that I see this is in writing. So I have a lot of students come to me who are, you know, big into math and science and tinkering, and often not big fans of English and writing. But technical writing and figuring out how to communicate concepts clearly to other people is a really important part of engineering, and they do a lot of writing in class. And it's a different kind of writing than most of them are used to doing. But because it's writing about something that they're really interested in and that they're invested in, and because they're writing for a real authentic audience, a lot of times they're sending design reports to professional engineers that have presented them with a challenge. They have that motivation and that sort of area of confidence in what they're talking about that lets them focus on improving their writing. And I see, you know, huge leaps from the start of the semester to the end in not only their ability to like follow technical writing style, but even in their, you know, their general mechanics and organization of their writing, because they're really focused on writing something that they care about.